Hi everyone, welcome back again. So this is the first video of FI load balancer series. Let's start. What is the load balancer? Load balancer is a device that acts as a reverse proxy and distributes the network or application traffic across number of servers which sits behind the load balancer. Let's understand what is the reverse proxy. This is the load balancer. At this side, users are here. At this side, servers are here. Users accessing these servers through load balancer. Users send the traffic to load balancer and load balancer send users traffic to servers on behalf of users. So all the time, servers are communicating with load balancer only. So therefore, load balancer is acting as a reverse proxy for servers. Load balancer distributes the network or application traffic evenly and on basis of different parameters and performance parameters of servers. What are those different parameters and performance parameters of servers? We will see that in next videos. Let's understand what was before load balancer. Before load balancer, we were using a DNS server for a redundancy purpose as well as for a load balancing purpose. So as we all know, what is the role of DNS server? On DNS server, there is a simply mapping of name to IP. Users send a DNS query to DNS server and server replies one after one server IP. For example, for first DNS query, DNS server will reply first server IP, that is 172.16.1.1. For second DNS query, DNS server will reply 172.16.1.2. For third DNS query, server will reply 172.16.1.3. And again, for fourth DNS query, server will reply 172.16.1.1. So this is the simple round robin load balancing method of using a DNS server. But in this case, in DNS server case, DNS server has no any idea about server, whether that device, the server device is up or down, whether the services running on server device is up or down, or any content is missing or not. DNS server has no any idea about it. But this is not the case in load balancer. As I told you, users send the traffic to load balancer and load balancer send the traffic to server. Okay, but so load balancer always monitor the server devices, whether that device physically up or not, the service running on that device that is properly running or not. Not only this, load balancer also monitors the content of each device, what user expect to see. If the content does not match user's expectation, load balancer will not send the traffic to that server device. So what are the benefits of load balancer? It increases scalability, it provides redundancy, it reduces downtime and increases performance. It efficiently manages failures, increases flexibility, it increases capacity, concurrent user connection in the sense, and reliability of application. Also, it improves all over performance of application by decreasing the burden on servers. There are two categories of load balancer. One is layer 4, second is layer 7. Layer 4 load balancer distributes the connections based on layer 4 protocol, and layer 7 load balancer distributes the connection based on layer 4 protocols. That's it. Thank you guys. That's it in this video guys. In next video, we will see the installation of load balancer, FI load balancer on VMware. If you are having any doubts, please let me know in the comment section. Goodbye.